Minecraft Snapshot 23w32a is out with vibration changes and follow-ups from last week's snapshot. My name is Sly Slime and I'm here to show you all the changes. Let's start with the Sculk and vibration changes. Vibrations no longer risk being lost on simulation distance limit, and a whole lot of changes to frequencies have been made in this version. Unequipping items now has a frequency of 4. Chiseled bookshelves being fed books by a hopper now count as a block change of frequency 11, as does turtle eggs cracking. A turtle egg hatching now counts as a block being destroyed on frequency 12. Using bone meal is now an item interaction frequency 3. Fire being put out by a splash water bottle is now frequency 12 for a block being destroyed. Evokers summoning vexes or fangs now count as a summon with frequency 14. A rabbit eating a carrot out of the ground now counts as a block change frequency 11, as does a sweet berry being eaten by a fox. And a camel eating a cactus from a player is now an eating event with frequency 8. In visual news, there are no longer floating pixels from the wild and eye armor trims when applied to chainmail helmets. The tide, silence, vex and wild armor trims no longer add extra pixels to the back of turtle helmets. And the skins and capes of LAN world hosts now render properly for other players that join that world. In the user interface, the furnace user interface is no longer entirely broken when the furnace is modified using commands. The boss bar contents now gets properly cut off instead of scaling down, and the boss bars no longer have extra pixels when using the high contrast pack. Also, when that pack is on, slider indicators now once again show up in the menus. In sound news, the subtitles for footsteps are now the generic ones instead of specific to the mob for mobs that have no unique step sounds. That includes llamas, pandas, drowned, ravagers, hoglins, zoglins, piglins, and piglin brutes. In stability news, a couple of bugs with errors showing in the log file have been fixed. The game no longer hangs if you use an invalid border size in a 9-slice MC meta file. And if you receive an invalid chat message from a server, the game now displays a placeholder message instead of disconnecting. This snapshot contains further networking optimizations on top of the ones made in the previous snapshot, and a new debug graph screen has been added that shows up if you hold down Ctrl and press F3. This shows two graphs, one for the amount of data transmitted over the network, and one for the current ping to the server. The data and resource pack versions have both been increased to 17. Like last time, I'll be making separate videos for those updates, so keep an eye out for those if you're interested in technical changes. And that's it for this time. My name is Sly Slime, thank you for watching, I'll see you next time.